Traffic signs have come a long way since their early days. Back then, signs did not move, bend, or break away, causing horrible consequences. That's why the Oklahoma Department of Transportation followed the Federal Highway Administration's requirement of the 1960s by installing a design that breaks away when a car hits it, reducing vehicle damage, but most importantly, it protects the driver from potential injury.
If a vehicle was to impact this, it is on a double post, a large sign. It is set, and usually with crash test and things like that, if a vehicle came off in here and was to hit that post, the bottom would break away and the post would push out and either have the sign go over the top of the car or be pushed out so that it's not coming through the windshield.
If the driving public is able to get to it, it is a breakaway design. And this is where we have the square post. It's one of the types where the car just hits the post and bends it over.
Essentially, what we want is if there is a roadway departure, the vehicle can safely impact that object and not injure the driver or cause a situation for the driver to lose control.
Some features of a breakaway sign include the slip base. When a vehicle hits a sign with the slip base, the force of the vehicle pushes the sign off its foundation, allowing for the vehicle to pass under it before it hits the ground. The signs are designed to prevent further damage and potential injury to the driver by allowing the vehicle time to clear under the sign after contact. This design also helps ODOT maintenance workers because it takes less time to install and repair.
These, we do have to replace the post. Sometimes we have to replace the signs and everything. It just depends on how damaged they are, but we could reuse the sign. We normally can't reuse this post. We can reuse the base. Sometimes the base does get damaged and we do have to reuse that. But I would say it's a relatively inexpensive design.
The guys can simply either drive a new anchor and set the square tube into the post or into the anchor and makes for a fairly quick repair. We want to make sure we keep the signs upright and straight. And part of that too is for nighttime reflectivity so that the light angle from the headlights is hitting it back and shining it back on it.
By following the FHWA's requirement, sign reflectivity and breakaway signs are just a small piece of how ODOT is keeping you on the road of safety.